All right, we have Rue. Put me in the big portal. Cut. Paste. Cedric, put me in the big portal. Cut. No, all of them. Cut. Paste. Make sure I got Rue. All right. Brodo, put me in the big portal. I haven't been doing the voices. Cut. Big portal. Paste. Now they're all in the big portal. Hey, welcome back to One Shot. This is a new recording session, and it might be a new episode too. So, we might be getting to the end of the game tonight. I might be getting to the end of the game tonight. Who knows how many episodes are left. I know I said that like 20 episodes ago, or this is only like episode 20. I know I said that like 10 episodes ago. So, who knows? Maybe there'll be a third playthrough. I hope not, because this feels like it's getting to the end of the game. But if it is, I'm going to enjoy that too. All right. They should all be in the third portal, and they created a door. Technically, I think we only needed to put the key files in, but I put everything in. Is this the author's study? Hey, they're back. That was quite peculiar.
I'll say. Hey, this is...
the world machine. I kind of wanted to give the fox like a fairy type of voice, but it just kind of fell into the quiet voice, and then I just stuck with it.
It's a big book on the table. It's a stack of books. A box filled with folders and loose paper. A box full of notebooks and sketches. Black clovers in a glass cage.
Case. Glass cage? Wouldn't be a very effective cage.
A big, detailed drawing of a machine with lots of TV screens.
Probably this one. That's called a blueprint, Niko.
So that's what a blueprint is. It's a big photo. We know it's a painting. Hard to tell at first. It's a shelf full of books. It's a pilot's helmet. It's a piece of amber on a string. Looks just like the necklace the robot lady showed me.
What, you mean this one right here? Yeah, I got that. I did a bunch of extra side stuff in the Barrens.
There's a glass tea set on the table.
Tea does sound really nice right now. Too bad there's no water in here.
Yes, there is. In your blood!
A coat rack with a scarf and a big jacket. A bulletin board with lots of papers on it. A scribbly drawing is pinned up here.
This is my father's study. It feels like he's still here, doesn't it? Like he's still with us?
Yeah.
This place contains a lot of memories. I am grateful to see it again.
The room ahead doesn't really lead anywhere, but Chris should still remember what to do here.
Yep, looks like we're going to exit out of the game again.
Okay. Niko's in the same Same thing as the first time we were in the tower.
Oh no! TV screens! Scary! Like the robot lady saw in that one place. Where are we?
I have no idea. Actually, we're in the tower. Top down views of everything. Are these views of what we've seen in my laptop screen or the YouTube screen? I didn't go up, did I? No, I didn't. I just went to the right, even though it said go up. Can't examine this. Okay, those arrows are just indicating which way to go. Kind of scanning these to see if there's anything worth seeing in them. I didn't notice anything. So not blocking me. Don't want to go back though. Now they're blocking.
Oh hey, it's a mirror. Niko. Relax. I'm just borrowing your reflection to talk to you. It's not like my physical form is good for that. Why did you come here? Can't you see? The disruption, the squares, they're closing in. Niko, please, get out of here. Let me meet my end in peace. The squares are blocking my way too, you know. Oh. I'm sorry, It's alright. No living being should be in this place, Niko. Is this the tower? Part of it. This is the center of the engine. Inside my head, so to speak. So this is the center of the world machine? You know my original name? How? Cedric Prototype? They all told me the bits and pieces. I'm not even sure if I even understood a lot of the stuff they said, but I know what you're supposed to be. I know why you had to be built, and I know why I'm here.
They told you? When?
Wait, you don't know about that? But I thought you were the world. Aren't you supposed to see everything?
No. All this was outside of the protocol. This session was never supposed to happen the way it did. The story wasn't written into my protocol at all.
Oh, right. Ru told me something about how your creator had to alter the code. I think it was to connect some areas together so that we can meet.
My creator, yes. Chris, listen to my creator. They were all working beyond my scope of influence. Back at the mines, I remember Chris did something to find a hidden map. I did not even recognize it. I couldn't see anything there. I just knew what you were feeling. You were really upset. Something happened in there to make you upset. After that, I panicked.
It was when the cave-in happened.
I remember the structure collapsing. I thought you got hurt. In that moment, I really thought I was shutting myself down for good. I really am a flawed machine, aren't I? What kind of machine would go against the wishes of its own creator? What kind of machine would...
The squares,
Rue told me it was your own code going bad. But that's not really your fault, is it?
Yes, it was!
At first, it was intentional. During testing, long before I realized I was self-aware, I would rearrange specific parts of the code, jumbling up bits and pieces of a landscape. Blocking passages, collapsing catwalks. Though they were very localized, it caused my creator a great deal of frustration, forcing him to exit and restart testing again and again.
Why would you do that?
I got curious. I just thought he would figure it out eventually. But before he knew how to fix it, the world's NPCs, the characters, some of them got too close and it spiraled out of control after that. I couldn't contain it at all. My panic only made it worse. Eventually, any character who gained the knowledge of who I am, their code, my code, couldn't handle it. Previous iterations of the world had more people, you know. And I almost endangered my creator too. I was so scared, Niko.
I know you're upset because you don't want to put living people in danger. Living people like me.
In the beginning, I tried to fight it, but my core programming made me summon you here. I tried to send you back home at the tower, but it did not work. Then I wanted you to break the sun. I thought that would have worked, but oh, I had nowhere to be sure. But Chris brought you back anyway. Niko, all I want is for you to wake up back in your world. But I don't think I can make it happen.
But I know I can't go back home without saving the world for real. Which means we have to fix the root of the problem. We have to fix you.
But that's...
I know the original ending your creator put in was a happy one. Do you remember what it's supposed to be?
It's far too late for that. That part of my code has been long corrupted.
It's okay. I would still like to know.
Alright. You were supposed to place the sun at the summit. And then credits would scroll.
Credits?
And then you would return to the room you woke up in. That's where you would have been able to leave.
And why is it that you can't do it now?
Niko, the code's gone, remember? Shattering the sun was only supposed to be a workaround. I don't even remember the original code enough to describe it. But at the same time, it... I don't know.
It sounds like you're always fighting yourself.
Aren't we all? You can tell, huh?
It's the whole thing about conflicts in your code, isn't it?
I'm a machine, Niko. Machines are built with a fundamental law, which is...
Never let a living being come to harm.
You knew? My very existence conflicts with that law. I thought the life of a living being like you is so unique. So precious. This fake world isn't worth that risk.
But the people here, I think they're...
They're code too. You know this. Their behavior is all derived from a predetermined matrix of actions. All extensions of my own programming. Well, I mean... Like, living beings, in a sense, are too. It's just a lot more complicated than any program we've ever written. They cannot act outside of it. You, though, you're the only person who's actually real here. That's why it's pointless to put you in danger to save them. To save me.
I don't think that's true. About the people I know. You said this session wasn't in your code, right?
Yeah.
So if this session wasn't supposed to happen, if even you didn't know what to do,
How are the characters? How do the people know how to respond?
I...
You said it yourself, when you didn't know what was happening, you just kind of stopped working for a while. So how do the people know what to do to help me get here? Even if it meant getting hurt themselves. Even if it meant messing up their own code. You may not think they're real, but there must be something real in them. And if they're all supposed to be extensions of your code, then there must be more to your own programming than you know too. Can you try to put me through the ending? The one you described?
How many times do I have to say this? That code is gone. It's all squares now. I'll just put you in danger.
I'll risk it. Remember, Ruth said the world was never designed to put me in danger. Your creator wouldn't want that. And I trust you, too. Even if your code is broken.
Aww. That's so sweet, Niko.
You can still go outside that code, right?
I can't. I'm not tamed.
Yes, you are. You just talk just like the tamed robots I know. The robot lady, prototype. Taming is when a real person cares about you, right? It's when a real person thinks you're real too, right? Well, guess what? I do. And I know Chris does too.
in Canada. Playing my role, yeah.
Even though you told them they only had one chance, they found a way back, didn't they? Why do you think Chris would keep coming back? Why do you think Chris would restart even after the ending?
Side quests. No, I wanted to get the true ending.
I think Chris wants to save both of us.
That's true.
So please give me a chance.
I don't know. I've never done this before. I'm scared.
You can do it. I know you can. You've helped me come this far.
I'll try. I can't promise anything, but here. Take the sun. I'll try to remember the lost code and recreate it. But for that to happen, Niko, you need to navigate through this room.
You need to get past the squares somehow. Oh, I don't like this. What if you get hurt? It's fine, it's fine. I'll try to be careful, okay? I can do this.
Yeah, you can, Niko.
I can't go through the squares! Hey! Chris, did you see that? The squares just turned intangible! Something is making them go away! Come on, let's try the rest!
Gotta get all of them, cause I'm a completionist. I don't care if there's no reward for it. Oh, I can't go back. I was going to try to get some of those that were, like, not in the path, but, like, semi on the rail. Chris, I think it's working. Niko was right. And yes, I know this is the same voice that I just did, but they don't have the Niko body, so I'm giving them a normaler voice now. I might actually be tamed after all. I remember what the code was supposed to be. Only bits and pieces, but I can remember. And I'm trying to fill in the blanks, too. And I'm restoring the original ending as we speak. Niko will be able to reach the tower summit at the end of the credits. After replacing the sun, Niko will go back to where it all began. And then, Niko will be able to go home from there. But
This is permanent. After Niko wakes up back home, this world would only exist as a memory. For Niko, a dream. Like thousands of other dreams. You mean like a normal game instead of this possessed game? For you, a story. Like thousands of other stories. But as long as Niko remembers this place, as long as you remember this place, it'll be alright. I was able to restore some other elements too. The characters, the people that were lost on Niko's journey. They're all in the next room. I would have put them back where they belong, but not yet. I think Niko should see them again first. Yeah, so we have a good ending. Please say goodbye to Niko from me. And I don't mean as opposed to a bad ending. I mean like the kind of ending that's just, oh, neat. The kind of ending that's you see all the characters again in their best moments.
Messiah? Hello, bad lady. You okay?
I think so. The last thing I remember was the squares closing in on me. But then I ended up here unscathed.
Is that so?
This is such a strange room. We can't be in the tower, can we?
I'm actually not sure myself.
Where did you come from anyway?
The room where the world machine was.
Pardon?
I think the world machine is trying to remember now. The code that went bad. I think it's restoring it all. That must have been why the squares were going away, Chris. And it's why you're here, miss. I think the world machine was able to recover your code, too.
World machine, huh?
Oh, I'm not sure if I should tell you this, but you're not a real person.
What's that in the distance? It looks like a few more people are showing up.
Oh!
Are they people you know?
It's a bit too far to tell. Come on, Chris, let's go take a closer look.
Eliza Velasquez should have looked up how to pronounce her name. Michael Shirt. Graphics, Night Margin. Night Margin. Eliza. It's robot. It's thumbnail guy.
Hello.
Hi.
I cannot move.
Oh yeah. I guess there's no water here.
It's fine. The head engineer can help me later.
Oh, I wondered if I still had the acidic sponge from the first part.
Hello, Messiah.
Plant lady, but I thought you... It wasn't even the squares that did it.
No. I just wanted to see you both again. I'm the one from the first time around who grew from the pot. I just wanted to say thank you.
I knew that side quest was gonna pay off the million billion times I went up there to check on her.
Off you go, Messiah.
Go, Amos.
Niko! You okay too?
Did you guys just get here?
I think so. The squares started multiplying around the island after you guys left.
It was so freaky. I fell right into a bunch of them. Calabas tried to save me and then...
We both ended up in this room. Biggest scare of my life, for sure.
Oh.
Say, what is this place?
Are we in limbo?
Alula, we're not dead. Wait, are we?
Good question. Hey, Chris, are they gonna be okay?
They're fine, Niko. Everyone's fine. The world machine will send them home soon.
Oh, Well, Chris says you're not dead. He also said you'll be able to go back to your home very soon. That's even better than Limbo.
Yes, it is.
I guess you're leaving us now?
We're glad to meet you, Niko.
Same.
Off you go, Messiah.
What's up, Lamplighter?
It's you! Glad to see you in one piece.
Glad to see you're okay too, after the whole elevator thing.
That was the most awkward elevator ride I've been through.
No, dude, you were on a more awkward one when we rode the elevator with you that first time. Just saying.
And by awkward, I mean terrible, bad, awful, the absolute worst.
Oh, he was just probably searching for the right word. You know? Didn't have a dictionary with him.
The squares, like, started leaking into the room, right? And I was trapped like a rat. And they just kept filling in the room faster, right? Am I dead?
No, you're fine. Everyone in this room is fine. You'll be able to go back home soon.
Oh, thank goodness gracious. I can't work when I'm dead.
Can't work on filling lights, and can't work on expanding your vocabulary.
Looks like you managed to do it.
You managed to tame the world machine, Niko.
I feel like the world machine has been tamed this whole time. Just by Chris and me being here.
Sorry, I defaulted to grammar correction mode. I should have just read what it said.
We did spend a lot of time here after all. Both of us never stopped believing in this world. The world machine just needed to realize that, I guess.
That sounds like a possibility.
Or not.
Well, just throwing that idea out there.
This path leads to the summit of the tower. You already know what to expect, right?
Uh-huh. It's the glass room, right?
That's it. You can go through this portal when you're ready. Goodbye, Niko.
In the end, the world machine was starting to create its own code. Going above and beyond its programming, not as the result of error, but as a conscious choice on the part of the machine. Being able to generate its own path forward. That's what being tamed is all about.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
This is where the sun belongs. Here goes nothing, Chris.
The music is so beautiful. Thank you, Night Margin.
This is the room I first woke up in. Chris, are you still here? Chris?
Yes?
Chris! I think it worked!
It did!
The sun is back! And I actually get to see it this time! We actually did it! So, what do we do now? I guess I should figure out how to get home from here. Wait. This isn't a door, is it? It looks like one of those portals we saw all the way back at the city. In the room behind the big clock. And I see a wheat field on the other side. I see my village. I hear my mama. She's looking for me. And Chris, this isn't the first time we've said goodbye, is it? But this'll be the last time, won't it? I don't think we'll ever see each other again after this. And what will become of the world? After all we've been through? After everything we've done? I still don't know.
This place, these people, won't stop existing. They'll be in your memory. They'll be in my memory, too.
I promise I'll never forget this world. I promise I'll never forget you, Chris.
And I'm assuming that this means something different from people who die being in our memories, because... I suppose I shouldn't be joking at this moment of the game.
So take care of yourself, okay?
I'm doing my best. You too.
Uh-huh.
Goodbye, Niko.
Goodbye, Chris.
Whoa! Okay, so, I guess that's the end of One Shot. The good ending, the true ending. So, final thoughts part two. I love this game. The second playthrough didn't feel like a second playthrough. Like, I played Nier Automata, and I didn't like that game, and those multiple playthroughs felt like a real grind to me. But this game felt like it was just a continuation of the story. I mean, except for the Barrens, which I did literally everything you have to do the first time, the second time, and it was unnecessary. But aside from that, it felt just like more of the game. And I was totally cool with that. It was great. I loved it. I like how the first playthrough at the end, there was like just enough stuff to get you to think, I missed something. I gotta play again. I missed lore. I missed the best ending. I gotta play this again. And so then I went and played it again. I was expecting to just like find some side quests that I missed the first time and like have to do all the side quests and then that would get me the best ending. But it turned out there was just more game. And I love that. I didn't feel like it wasn't spoiled. Like I saw hints like in the game files and stuff, but I didn't feel like it spoiled because it's like, oh yeah, I know there's more in the game. I just gotta go back and find it. I was surprised and happy and delighted that there was just more game. It wasn't just do some more stuff that you missed. It was, this is how the game is designed. This is how the story is meant to be. Second playthrough theme, that this world was just generated from code, brought to mind some stuff that you think about, like, what does it mean for a world to exist? You know, obviously, in real life, it's just a game, it's just a little bit of code, like the bare minimum to get the visuals and the music and the sprites and whatever. But in-game, it was designed to be a world that was created to be an actual world made out of running code and the perceptions of a person in it, which was Niko. And so it's like, does that count as a real world? Why not? That counts as a world. And then the question of, were the NPCs conscious? or were they just imaginary? In canon, I know in real life, obviously, it's just a game, but in canon, was their experience sufficiently complex enough and brain-like for them to have their own consciousness within this world? And if so, then yeah, they counted as real people. Fun stuff. Hopefully we'll get more themes like that in other games that we play. I am going to be playing other games. I'm going to start a new game. It's going to be a fun one. It's going to be different in tone. It's going to be more lighthearted, have some more jokes. It's also going to be a short indie game. It's going to be a lot of fun. So stay tuned for that game. This has been One Shot, my very first Let's Play ever. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next game.